All right, today in Tip of the Week, we're going to talk all about Facebook Shops. It's a new e-commerce functionality that Facebook's rolling out. I heard about it over the last couple of weeks. I didn't know quite what was going on. And so, Kyle, are you ready to jump into this? You've been researching
Ready.
All right, so you've really kind of poked around and researched what this is, how it's going to work. So in this conversation, let's jump in. Let's learn more about Facebook Shops. And Kyle, take it away. Share what you've learned.
Absolutely. So this has been an evolving goal for Facebook for quite a while. I mean, in the past, they'd connected with your Shopify store, and you could actually have products visible on your Facebook page, and they would link back into your Shopify store. And then they went away with that because what they're trying to do is roll out an integrated platform that Facebook could then connect with in their ecosystem, have Instagram part of it, and really provide a seamless experience. And also, they didn't really want to be sending people off of Facebook's platform to begin with.
Of course.
Right?
Yes, so, of course.
Because they're making money on ads.
Yeah.
So that was their primary goal. So this was sort of their solution that they came up with. And there's also the other driver of this is that Facebook wants to compete with Amazon for e-commerce and for online sales and advertising dollars. And if you have where people are at and can actually transact, then it's an easier sell for the advertiser to spend money with Facebook if it all is occurring in the same platform. So
sure. In
essence, that's where they end up, you know, coming to. So their goal really is to have the full collection, all your products. They have what they call the e-commerce manager section now in Facebook Business.
Okay.
You can go ahead and you can get set up. And what their goal is, it's just like if you were uploading product and images and all the different things that you would go through, except if you were setting up on any other marketplace.
Uh-huh.
The cool thing is that the benefit for Facebook is it gives you actually multiple channels to look at. So obviously you have the Facebook feeds you'd be familiar with, but then they're rolling and integrating it into their Instagram platform as well.
Okay.
And starting, I think, in this summer, I believe, in the US, they're gonna have Instagram Shop, which is kind of connected to Facebook Shops and Instagram Shops are all gonna be integrated together.
Sure.
But it'll be a place where you can browse selections from brands and creators and categories, and it'll be a discoverability feature on Instagram that they're gonna use that ties it into the Facebook shopping experience.
Okay.
That'll be native to Instagram. So they're bringing it all together into one key functionality and piece. The other thing that'll be interesting is that it'll show up, you'll have your Facebook page, and then you'll say, click visit shop, there'll be a button. And then you have this sort of immersive experience inside of Facebook that'll look sort of like a store, like your own Facebook version of a store to sell product. That's going to be the shopping experience. And then they check out right inside Facebook, and then Facebook's going to be the one that then sends you the money.
So, okay. So just to clarify, I'm on Facebook Shops or whatever. I see a lead, a journal.
Right.
I click buy. It's a Facebook checkout shopping cart.
Yes.
But you've rigged it up on the back end so that you're fulfilling through your Shopify store.
The fulfillment will occur through your Shopify store.
Okay. Right. Because this is done in partnership with Shopify.
Right. Yeah. Okay. Correct.
All right.
Now, so you're going to get all the fulfillment. Think of it almost as an additional marketplace scenario.
It's a sales channel.
Exactly. Yeah. It's a sales channel. So just like if you had a sale through eBay, you're still going to fulfill that like you normally would. And eBay pays you. And Facebook's going to pay you in the exact same way. So you're going to get paid. So you have to go through, there's a setup process that you have to go through and get approved and you know, vetted as a real business and all the different things that you want to do.
Dude.
So, but it's going to be really interesting. The other thing that caught my eye was what they're also trying to do, and they're still testing this is all still in beta, but they want to connect loyalty programs to your Facebook account so that people can earn rewards with businesses and loyalty points that exist in Facebook and can accrue.
Wow.
So they can easily track all the points and rewards for across all the different stuff that they're doing all in one place and spend them in your Facebook Shops and be able to use that and have an ecosystem built around loyalty programs.
Wow. Okay. So a few questions that are immediately come to my mind beyond just, you know, just the basics. Do you know how this fits into the Facebook Marketplace functionality or where you can currently sell stuff?
Yeah, I think it's Yeah, local exactly. Stuff? I'm not sure the exact integration with it. I think this is more going to be designed for e-commerce transactions, where Facebook Marketplace is more of the local,
like Craigslist.
Craigslist type thing. Okay. It wouldn't surprise me though that there would be some level of integration with that.
Yeah.
Only because even now you can run ads on Facebook Marketplace. So you can advertise products and services and all these different things as that, as a channel.
Yeah.
When you set up your Facebook ads. So if you have e-commerce products and you can sell them online, it would not shock me one bit that they actually make that as part of a advertising channel for online products and actually featuring shops and stuff like that they would do. If people are looking for products, it won't matter if they buy it in person or online.
Yeah. Okay. Well, this is fascinating. You know, this is obviously the largest social website in the world rolling out extended, you know, functionality in an interesting way for e-commerce. Now, so at the high level, yeah, it's basically what's occurred now is there were omni-channel selling for e-commerce used to be eBay, you know, Amazon, then you had Jet, which just got closed. Walmart closed it. I don't know if you heard that, but anyway,
that was $1 billion. Oops.
Well, they just
took all the tech. Yeah, they took all the tech. Yeah.
Anyway, so you've got the traditional omni-channel sales opportunities. But then in the last couple of years, you know, the social media sites have pushed into e-commerce a little bit. But it seems as if with this announcement, Facebook has really got a clear strategy that they're going to, you know, they've kind of been wandering around in this space. And so that's interesting. I'll just point out that we can do a whole different topic on this later. Pinterest is also rolled out. Mm-hmm. It's a big announcement this week. Pinterest begins rolling out shopping spotlights. Recommendations from fashion and home taste makers and publishers will be featured now in Pinterest. So it's pushing into e-commerce as well. So you get the idea here that the social media companies have realized, man, why don't we get in the biz of direct selling? Because why not keep people on our social media sites and make more money? So there's a lot of value proposition being created here for e-commerce sellers. So that's very cool.
Definitely.
Well, so if people want to learn more, what do they do? Is there a shop homepage, or is it in the business manager section of Facebook?
There's a couple of things, and we can include the links in the show notes as well. And there's basically there's the promo where Facebook talks about it and does a little video. And then there's a step-by-step how to set up the e-commerce manager in the help section, and I can link to both those things. And the setup process is going to be—it's pretty straightforward. Obviously, you can—if you don't need to get approved to sell on Facebook pay on your Facebook page, you still obviously you have to comply with their policies for commerce and merchant. You do need to make sure you're selling stuff that's eligible for retail inventory if you want to sell through the marketplace, because that is an option. I was looking a little bit deeper on that as well. And then to sell on Instagram, you have to get approved first.
Yeah. Okay.
So as long as you're doing those things, the thing that's also in beta with this is the integration with Shopify. They're doing a direct linked integration with them as a partner, and that's still in beta. You can apply for the beta. And you just go through and you fill out a form and say, hey, I'd like to apply for it. But there's no guarantee when that will allow you to occur. But
I got to tell you, as a digital goods seller, 9 days out of 10, I think I'm so glad I sell digital goods and not physical goods. But when it comes to these types of extensions, they always exclude the digital sellers. So I can never participate in these things. In the past, I've looked into it. It's always a bummer. So if you're a physical product seller and you've got a Shopify account, you should absolutely be looking into this. It's going to be a fantastic opportunity. I kind of had said, just as this is my final comment, I had said, and I wrote an article even for McGraw-Hill saying, is Facebook the yellow pages of 30 years ago? And in that article, I basically said, you know, in terms of a social media site, people are leaving. The eighth graders left, the 10th graders left, the college students left. It's just the grandparents that are there now. But one of my comments was the only way Facebook is going to stay relevant is if they move into taking over, basically either killing Craigslist by becoming the new Craigslist or moving into e-commerce more and taking advantage of transactional, you know, e-commerce work. That could be their salvation. Mm-hmm. And I think that's what they're doing. So yeah, I mean,
100%.
Yeah. All right, man. Well, this is great stuff. So we'll have links underneath this video. If you like this topic and you think Kyle is amazing and all that he knows and you want his help setting up your selling system, we're working with clients every day through our coaching program, helping them set up, you know, on multiple platforms.
Stuff like this.
Exactly.
Literally doing this for clients.
Yeah. And so if you want our help, check out our coaching program. It's available on our website, winningonshopify.com. There's an application you go through. We want to make sure we're right for you and you're right for us. And so, so check that out if it's of interest. We'd love to help you explore this further for your business. And with that, let's wrap it up. Great session, man.
This is good stuff. Exciting times to be in e-commerce.
No doubt.